Okay, so we've defeated 7 bosses. And we have to backtrack through 5 stages. So there's 2 places where I got everything. First thing I'm going to do is pick up the head attachment, because the head attachment will show me exactly what I'm missing. So yeah, I mean, you can go back and pick this stuff up earlier, but you wind up making trips. It's just takes a little play. But yeah, it's something that you can do if you gotta. So let's see. This takes the Triad Thunder plus the Buster upgrade. So punch the ground. I can get to the heart tank. Oh, something I didn't mention the last time through here is those things are sort of like sand that falls on top and kind of knocks you down into place. So see how it kind of blows them here. And yeah, if you're over spikes when that happens, it's bad news. So just push it out there. They only show up in bosses that you have not defeated. And they will always show up at least once. So I think if you get a game over, they'll quite a bit disappear. As you can see earlier, I did die once. This head piece will do 2 things. It will add a display to the world map that will show me what item pieces are in each level that I've missed, and also when I first enter into a level, it will show me kind of a map with any items that are missing. So see, there's a map of the level with nothing in it, and that should signify that there's nothing left in here to pick up. Alright, so that was the Tunnel Rhino level. And so as you can see, I'm scrolled over Tunnel Rhino, and Life Up, S-Tank, and Headpiece are all grayed out. And so the same should be with the Tiger, Life Up, Sub-Tank, and Arm Part. See, my next stop is... Oh, first I want to make sure that Blast Hornet is also grayed out, except for the question marks. So those question marks are gold armor pieces. And remember, you don't want to pick them up until the end. You can get the hyperchip so that you can get all 4 pieces for the upgrade. So that's good with Blast Hornet. Next stop is Volt Catfish. That's Volt Catfish. To pick up the sub-tank. The body part. Yes, armor is very good to have in this game, as you can see with all the damage I've taken. And so yeah, there's little red spots in the level. This part here in the beginning is this is sort of an interesting use is the gravity shot charged up. Fire the gravity weapon plus the best part. Yeah, you receive less damage on the defensive shield. Stop is Gravity Beetle. So remember how I talked about certain stages changing depending on what order you fight the bosses. So after you defeat Blast Hornet, there's some the cargo here in this stage is being moved, and it allows you access to the tanker. Buffalo stage. Pick up a piece of right armor here, and instead of proceeding to the lobby, I'm just going to punch through these blocks right here. And part piece. Okie dokie. So the last place we backtrack to is to crush Crawfish. Thank you. second platform here, punchy wall, and here's the heart. So now that I've done all the backtracking, I can actually continue on through this level and head right to Vile. Yeah, it'll be kind of a long video, but, people who tell the type file, they'll just have to scroll to the end. Alright, so this takes us to the Vile stage. No matter what external stage you start from, this is where you line up. Allow us to go through the catfish's stage. Still in the same place. So yeah, while he's in his ride armor, it's the same wall and dash as Roman Love. Of course it's the end. You're blowing up. Well, the end for this game anyway. I'm sure you'll be back in another installment. Alright. So, this next part is timed. So, if I go super quiet, I'm just gonna focus. Go. 13 seconds left to spare. So we've defeated Vile and done all the backtracking. We've got everything except for the last pieces in the Toxic Seaspore stage. So we done good.